Brazil then through to the knockout stages. They're joined by Venezuela, who beat Bolivia by 3-0. Boys, we've been harsh on Brazil, haven't we, so far this tournament? Very poor compared to what we would expect from them, but they were so much better.
Yeah,
well,
Well, they were, but they were aided and abetted by by some horrific decision making from Peru. Some poor defending. The first goal was a set piece, flick on, Casemiro gets in. That's kind of well worked. Sometimes that's hard to defend. The second goal, he's only got to pass it. What have I always said about goalkeepers? Brain dead. He's only got to pass it 10 yards with no block. And he tries to fire it up through a yellow jersey that stood right in front of him. Right, simple part. Then you're 2-0 down, chasing the game. And then he gets beat at his near post. Then something else happens, I can't remember.
Everton in the near post.
Everton in the near post. And then he comes out like a bull in a china shop and gives a penalty away. Yeah. So there's 3 goals.
Sure.
There's 3 from nothing. So it's hard to... I mean, it's better from Brazil.
Yeah.
Of course it is. It's a wee bit more excitement. But it's hard to look past the gifts they got from Peru.
But Peru aren't a bad side.
They are today.
You know, a team that's unbeaten. Oh, I know, in the leading up to this game, beat Bolivia, drew against Venezuela. Yeah. So you look at that sense...
Well, beat Bolivia, drew against Venezuela. That's hardly number-crunching, is it?
But the problem is, if we're holding Brazil to the standard in which we have over the last few games...
Brazil, Venezuela...
They laboured so much in those two games, didn't they? They were terrible against Venezuela and the first half against Bolivia.
I tell you why they're terrible, because they're not a very good Brazilian side.
But they were much better today.
Have you been listening to the last minute and 30 seconds?
I know, but I don't think you're giving them enough credit. There was some spark.
I don't care what you think.
No,
I'm telling you for a fact. Peru gave away 3 goals. 3 goals.
I understand that.
Right.
However...
So, is that aiding... Is that helping Brazil to look better?
Yes, most definitely. Right. But Brazil helped themselves look better as well. This is the best we've seen Brazil in this tournament.
Because they've been poor, absolutely awful to watch, and Peru... were there for the taking, and they gifted them 3 goals out of 5. It's hardly... I mean, I wouldn't buy a ticket to watch this Brazil team.
You wouldn't buy a ticket to watch anybody.
Well, there is that. But I certainly wouldn't buy a ticket. I've watched many Brazilian teams over the years, and they've got me out of my seat. This one, no.
Final third, they look much sharper. Everton...
I go to Shaq and ask that. I'm done.
Listen. If you're Brazil, given what you saw in the first two games, you take this result without question. And you hope that it's a spark for what's to come in the knockout round. Am I getting carried away as a neutral? No, I'm not. I still think Brazil have a lot to do to prove themselves in this tournament.
They just won 5-0.
But you get a scoreline that I think kind of warrants a boost in confidence, because I think this team has been playing within themselves because they've been a little bit nervy in front of their home crowd, given some of their performances.
Let's welcome Julian Laron into the show. Jules, Xhaka makes a good point, doesn't he, in the sense that those opening two games...
What about Craig? Did Craig make a good point?
Craig made terrible point. But this just seemed to add the pressure, didn't it, on Tite's shoulders, those two matches. Very poor performances. No matter who the opposition and how many gifts they got in this game, it will relieve that pressure a little bit going into the knockout stages.
Yes, certainly. And the early goal after just 12 minutes would have eased the nerves on the game for the players, for Chichi, for the fans as well. That was the perfect start for them. And, I mean, they couldn't have been worse or as bad even than in the Venezuela game, for example. This time, everything went their way. And Craig is right. You know, they got a lot of help by that, how poor that Peruvian side. But Everton was far more lively than Richarlison was against Venezuela, for example. That worked better. And Firmino, I thought, was much better as well. So there's some improvement, but if they want to win this Copa America on home soil, they would have to be even much better than they were tonight.
They want to win it. It's never been an easier time to win it.
The standard isn't high.
Is not what it used to be. And that includes Brazil. So I suppose it's all kind of relative. But the kind of state Argentina are in as well. You know, you're looking at Uruguay and Colombia, who, particularly Uruguay, who are normally... got a very sound structure. And Colombia are always a tenacious side with a bit of flair. But, you know, if they don't win it on home soil, and I think they've always have when it's been in Brazil, if they don't win it, I think that asks even more questions because of I think, how far some of these teams have regressed.
For more, sign up now for ESPN Plus.